Blackstone Publishing presents The Peaceful Valley Crime Wave by Bill Pronzini. This book is read by Nick Sullivan. For Marcia. Chapter 1. Peaceful Bend is a peaceful town. Peaceful Valley, a peaceful place. Now, I know a lot of folks say that about where they hang their hats, some with more justification than others. It's a matter of civic pride fashioned on a sense of security and neighborly goodwill. That's the way it is in Peaceful Bend, the largest town and county seat, and all through the valley. Ranchers, farmers, merchants, businessmen, all living peaceably together in as pretty a section of northwestern Montana as you could ask for. The town tucked into a crook in a fork of the Flathead River, the valley surrounded wide on three sides by timbered mountains. It wasn't always peaceful here, of course. Way back before the century turned, when I first pinned on a badge as a young green deputy, we had our share of trouble, the same as any other small settlement. Renegade Indians, outlaws, rustlers, the general run of riffraff that follow the railroads, lumberjacks on a spree, and the usual land and water rights feuds between cattlemen and farmers. Took a sharp eye, a strong will, an iron fist, and now and then both ends of a Colt 6-gun to tame things down. The natural flow of progress, changing attitudes, modern inventions, new laws, rounded off the rest of the rough edges. By the time I was elected to my first term as sheriff in 1896, both the town and the country were living up to their names right proper. I don't mind saying I've had a fair hand in making and keeping it that way, the voters having kept me in office for 2 decades now. You won't find many citizens who'll take the name of Lucas Monk in vain. Not bragging on myself, just stating a fact. The state has changed considerable in those 2 decades. More and more crisscrossing rail lines connecting it with the rest of the country. A large population growth, some 15 million immigrants since 1900 come to work on the railroads and in the mines, smelters, and lumber camps. A homestead boom thanks to legislative acts that opened up sections in national forests and Indian tribal lands. More and more motor cars mixing in with the horse-drawn conveyances, the countryside and city streets filling up with telephone poles and hydroelectric power lines. Even flying machine exhibitions at the Fort Missoula Baseball Park. Reform movements aplenty, too. Labor unions, one of them the radical bunch known as the Wobblies that caused so much trouble in Butte, the governor had to call in machine-gun-toting National Guard troops to curb the violence. Another, the Nonpartisan League, made up of farmers that didn't like big business and didn't support either of the political parties. Women were on the cusp of being given the vote, and about time, too, the main reason being a Missoula suffragist named Jeanette Rankin, who held rallies and meetings all over the state, including one in Peaceful Bend that drew more folks than any other event ever had, and raised enough support to convince the politicians in Helena to allow her to address the legislature. There was even talk of running her for a congressional seat on the Republican ticket come the 1916 election, which, if they did, and she won, would make her the first woman ever elected to Congress. These changes affected Peaceful Bend, naturally, but not as much as they did the larger towns. Northwestern Montana is less populated than the rest of the state, our entire county having only about 1,700 souls, according to the most recent census. And while Peaceful Valley isn't what you'd call isolated, Missoula, Kalispell, Helena are only a few hours away by train, we're still a small rural county with most of the land in long-held hands. Folks hereabouts tend to cling to some of the old ways of thinking and doing things. The revolution down in Mexico, and the war that had flared up in Europe a few months back, had tongues wagging, but those hostilities were too far off and the particulars too mystifying for most citizens to dwell on. Seemed like America would stay well shut of the one overseas, a good thing for the country in general and Peaceful Valley for certain. We had enough concerns of our own to occupy our thinking.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.